Welcome to Lumina Nails. In this video, I'll be showing you all the things that I've bought recently from Shein. And I did buy all these. These were all bought with my own money. Just want to clarify that in case anybody wants to know. I'm not a big enough channel to like receive sponsors or free stuff. So yeah, let's get started. Everything I say I recommend, I truly do recommend. And if I can still find it, I'll add the link in the description box. If I can't find it, I'll just tell you what the name was or the product, you know, description so that you might be able to find it elsewhere. So starting off here, I did not buy this from Shein, but I'm showing you this to explain. So I have this Melody Susie drill. It's a Sylvia nail drill. It was just a simple nail drill I bought. It's a little handheld one like this. It's not very fancy. I bought some drill bits for this because I don't really care for the ones that came with it. I have used them. They've gotten dull, a couple of them. But these sandpaper ones are just too strong. They're too high of a grit. I don't even know. This is like full-on like sandpapering a table grit here. And I don't recommend this for use on human nails, which they, like, these are my actual nails. So, sorry they don't look good right now. I'm in the process of changing them. But these are my nails, and I just don't trust using the red ones. So I did buy some other drill bits and some drill bits to replace these. This is one of them. And it came in this bag of six. And I bought these because it came in with my favorite style of cuticle cleaners. As well as, sorry about the noise. So it came with all of these, including the one that's already in the drill. These two are good for filing down gel. I've used the yellow one. It works really good on gel, like excellent on gel. I would say this rougher one probably worked good if you're using it on some thicker glitters, but I'm still a little worried about using that on my natural nails. And then these two ball ones are really good for around the cuticle. And I like this flat one for toes. So I bought those. It came in a set of six. And I bought these two to replace the ones that have gone dull in the Melody Susie. So these two, they all work really great. I highly recommend them as like replacements if you're running out. The next thing I have here is these little cleanup sticks. You can go around the cuticle and clean up, or you can clean up like one little area with them. There's cotton on this side and it's wood. So I'm guessing like the whole thing can probably be thrown in the compost or something because it is all natural fibers. But this is the bag it comes in. It comes with, I think, like 100 or something like that, maybe 200, I'm not sure. But I bought these. I've seen people with the pink ones, but I just don't feel like it's right to buy the pink ones because they are plastic, and that just means more landfill waste. These ones are recyclable, and these ones, you can also just easily like roll a little bit of cotton on the end of them if you're like in need of a little more. They're also a little easier to hold than a lot of the things, or like Q-tips or something like that. So I highly recommend those. Next up, we have these two nails. They're fake nails. I bought them both and with the idea of like decorating them myself, sort of personalizing them. I just haven't decided how I want to personalize them. I'm pretty sure these were on sale, so like half off for the white ones. And then these beige ones, they have an odd like edge to them on the bottom where I'm going to have to file them to shape to my nails. And it might just be because my nails are like a little too rounded, you know, near the cuticle. That might just be the problem I'm having, but they're all very like box shaped, so I'll probably have to round those out. They're both very cheap. Next up, we have this, which I've already used, and I'll show you how I use it. I just dip them, swatch the color that I want on them, and then I write the name of the color or the gel on the top of them. And I like this shape over the other shape, and I'll show you the other shape in a second. I like this shape. I've bought this for like 3 or 4 times, and I really prefer this shape, but this is just for my swatching. The other shape that I found on these, this shape right here. I've seen people use these to swatch on. I've also seen people actually like do nail art on these, which I think would be really nice if you want like a good size nail. But those are the two shapes. I have these. I haven't used these ones yet. I have used the flat ones. So, either way, they're really good for swatching your gel polishes if you need something so that you can have, like, a quick display of the colors, like, the true colors rather than looking at the labels. Next thing I have is this little bag. I bought these. They're little round, like, plastic, rounded, like, dome plastic things. They have a flat side and a round side. I paint the flat side with the gel polish. Then I wipe off the tacky layer after it's been cured. And I use the sticky things in here, the double-sided tape in here, like this one. So this is a model one. So this is 0441. And I did that with this. So I can see what color it is. Like the model ones, you can see the color through the window. But if I'm just looking over it, like over the top, then I can see the color, the true color. Next up, I have these. These are so great. These are like, as you can see, I've already used them. So one side is like this, where they're thicker cotton. But the other side is like this. And I have used from this side, it just doesn't look like it. They're really thin. And these I like because I can fold these up and take my tweezers like this and just like create this like nice point on them and then just go around if I'm trying to clean up something. So they're really great, and they were surprisingly cheap, really good quality, and they come in such a nice container. I'm really shocked by it. So this container that I've already started filling up because I've been trying to sort out all my like favorite nail art decorations and then my like not used ones. So we have all of them here that are like in the process of being sorted. This one comes double-sided. I have the ones that are like single sides, like just one row of it, but this one I thought it'd be easier to keep everything in. So they all come out like in fours, and each one opens up. So in here you can sort of see that like I have all these crystals in here that eventually I'll get around to using. And besides that, the other things I bought was like this set here, which are these soft gel tips. There's 240 per box, 12 sizes. And I bought these because when I take off these nails, I'm planning on doing just for fun one of those extra long sets. So I look at that like, can I wear that? Probably not. Will I be able to get even a day out of these? No, but that will be so much fun to just do a fun, like crazy set with. And what's nice is the smallest one here actually fits my pinky. These like hearts, these rainbow hearts, there's two different sizes in each one, I think. So silver, then teal, dark green, light green, a darker pink, light pink, like a bronzy orange, red, pinky, magenta-y, purpley magenta-y, and like a turquoise, and a cobalt blue. So very pretty glittery hearts. And lastly, I bought this, and this is just a wheel of, well, a flower, I guess, of so much. I put this on here so that I would remember which side was up because I keep opening it up upside down. So there's so many fun decorations inside of here. Like, look at all of these. Just, oh my god, like a little teddy bear. Look at that little teddy bear. Like, will you focus? No, you won't focus, but look at that teddy bear. And like, look at this. So cute. So probably gonna use those on the extra long nails that I bought. But that's what I got. That is my little assortment from Shein. Something that was fun to buy. Once again, I'll try to leave everything in the description box if I can find the link to it. I will. If not, then I'll try to find something comparable. So thank you for watching. I hope that this was useful. I'm not sure. I've never done one of these before. So, have a great day. Bye-bye.